beautiful crochet lovers, I'm Susanna. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I would like to show you how to crochet this very airy and nice look halter neck airlined camisole. This is very easy project, so if you are beginners, please try this. This is very easy, and the reason why I chose this pattern was very easy to increase, so you can make airline very easily. And also the amount of yarn is not so much, so it's kind of a quite quick project. And look at the back panel, and this is button opening. The reason why I chose this, it's be easy to open. Okay, like this. And you can change the button position if you want to make it tighter, please sew the button here. And if you want to make looser, please sew here so you can adjust. The buttonhole is here so you can like this. Okay, this is the string, and I prefer longer string because it's easy to handle. And also, this is top down camisole, so it's very simple. And today we only use double crochet and single crochet only, so it's very easy. Okay, so let's talk about the materials and patterns. Materials that I used is this yarn, that is cotton and linen blended, 60% cotton and 40% linen. This is the material, and 50 grams 125 meters or 2 ohms and 129 yards. And in my project, approximately 200 grams and approximately 500 meters. And crochet hook, this is Japanese size, but you can use the similar size. This is size 5/0, 3.0 millimeter hook, this one. And please choose the suitable hook to obtain the gauge. The gauge is like this. Single crochet is 20 stitches and 25 rows, and double crochet is 20 stitches and 12 rows. Okay. Also, maybe you can use this kind of scarf yarn. And this is 150 grams and 645 meters. So maybe you can use this one. This is acrylic blended. So that is a little bit lighter, lightweight, thinner, thinner, but still okay, maybe. So if you are not sure, please use two strands together. This is 200 grams and 800 meters. So this is also, you can use a single or double stranded. Okay, so let's talk about the measurement. Okay, so let's talk about the checklist. Please check these five sizes. The first, please determine your under bust size. In my case, it's 75. It's approximately 30 inches. And the bust cup, in my case, B. The number 3 is top under height. That is a little bit tricky, so let me explain. I would like you to check your bust height. So this is the top of the bust, and this is the under bust. Usually, please you tend to check the length from under bust to the top bust, but this is long. Please check the height, actual height. So from the front, that is, you can see the height, right? So top of the bust to the under bust. So please check the height here. The reason why you cannot check the length from under bust to the top bust, it's going to be longer, and it's going to be the cause that to make your bra part not fit to your size. First, I did like this, but it didn't work for me. So I changed this one. So let's compare. This is the top, and this is the top as well. So it is much, much shorter than this one. Like this here and here like this. Okay. So please check the total top under height. This is for the bra part. And next is total height from under bust. So please check the length you want from under bust. The bra part and the strings cannot change, so please check the how long you want. If you want to make a dress, please check the length you want, like this. In my case, I prefer 27 centimeters. It is approximately 10.5. And the last one is hip size or the circumference is on the bottom. So if you want to make a dress, please check the circumferences for walking comfortably, move comfortably, something like that. If you're not sure, please check your clothes and check the size. Okay. In my case, I prefer 35.5 inches. So I will going to make this size. Okay. So this is the checklist. And after check everything, we can start crochet. Okay, first step, we have to determine the foundation stitches. How? That is very easy. So let's check the number sleeve. Top under height. So this size, this is a foundation stitch. In my case, 3 or 1.5. And according to the gauge, 3 centimeters means 6 stitches. I start with 6 stitch. And the height of the top bust and under bust is tend to be changed by the age or by the sizes. If you are younger, your top bust will be higher than the older people. And also, if you have a larger bust, I mean the cup, if you have a larger cup, the height is going to be longer than the smaller cup, okay? So this is a very, you know, changeable size. So please pick your size. I made some list of the size of the, where is it? Here. This is a foundation stitches and these are part low numbers. So if you see this chart, you can check how many stitches you have. Okay, I will show you later. Anyway, please check your foundation stitch. After you determine the foundation stitch, let's crochet the puller part together. That is very easy and very enjoyable. Okay, so let's start crochet. So please make a slip knot. And please make a chain. Let me chain, make 6 chains. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So first, let me check the length. It's approximately 3, but it's okay. Let me try. And please make chain 1. And let's see the chains. There is a back bump here, so into the second back bump. So skip the first one and into the second one. This one. Please make the first single crochet. And please make single crochet into following stitches. 2, 3, 4, 5. There is a 1 chain left. And please make 3 single crochet into this chain. Okay. Then please make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 single crochet on the opposite side. One, two, three, 4. Five. Okay, this is the first row, so just three at the end and one each. Then move to the second row, and in that case chain 6 is going to be 13 stitches and 8 is 70 stitches, 21 25 29 33 37, like that. Okay, move to the second row. Please make chain 1 and turn your work. Please make a single crochet and please add another single crochet at the end of this row. 2, 3, 4, 5 here, but as you remember, we made 1, 2, 3 stitches, so we increased here, so we need another single crochet. So actually I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this is the center stitch and at the top, so the top we always make 3 single crochet like triangle, 1, 2, 3. Then please make 6 single crochet again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So shape is like a boat. Okay, so now I increased part 1 at the end. So after finishing the second row, the stitch is going to be 15, 19, 23, 27, 31, 35, 39, like that. Please increase, we are going to increase 2 stitches per round. So the round 3 is going to be like this. And when you finish the measurement, so please make the, you know, this length is the this one, and this height is going to be this height. So let's continue. All right, move on to row 3. So let's crochet together one more time so that you can master how to crochet the blur part. Okay, chain 1 and turn your work. So first 5 single crochet and next is 6 single crochet and next is 7 single crochet in my case. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here is the top, so please make 3 single crochet in a stitch. 1, 2, 3 in the same stitch, and then back to the end, so we are going to make 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Actually I'm a middle-aged woman, so I don't need the high part, because the shape of the body is different by the age or generations. In my case, I think this will work for me. Okay, and then chain 1 and turn your work, and then please let's continue. So next is 9, 5, 6, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 3 again. 1, 2, 3. And 8 again. And this is actually linen blended, so if you don't like it, please use a cotton or silk blended cotton yarn. so texture is more soft. Okay, like this. So please continue. So now shape is like a more roundy. All right, I believe now you understand how to crochet the pull-up part like this. Okay, before start our edging, crochet edging, let's determine how many rows you have to crochet. All right. So the part rows number 2, and that is according to your under bust. And this is another chart that I made. So my under bust is 75. So check the 75. In that case, there are two numbers, 15 or 17. The 15 is for short and 70 for long. Okay, what's that? This is the long and short. If you are a smaller cup, you don't have to make it longer, right? So it's going to be okay with short. And if you have larger cup, it's better to make it longer. So please choose long. Or please check out the edging design. The actual stitch number is going to be same as I believe. And this is 6 that I started. The 6 stitches that I started. And I can choose 15 or 17. So let's find 15 and 17. Here is 15 and here is for 17. In 15, 41 and 17, 45. There are 4 stitches difference. Look at this design. 15 is 15 by 2. This is short and this is short. 15 by 2 is 30. And 1, 2, 3, 4. So plus 4. So the width is going to be 34 stitches. How about row 17? Row 17 is 45 here. The row 17 is row 17 by 2 is 34. And the width is 34. So still same. So actually, the width is the same, but design is different. Look at here. This is started from the bottom of the shell scallop here. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 double crochet and here scallop. And look at another sample. This is here and here is scallop, but still there are still stitches here. There are 1, 2, 3 doubles. So this is in between shell. So the design is like this in the middle, and this is finished. So it's a preference. If you prefer this design, please choose long. If you prefer this design, please choose short. Okay, in that case, the height is shorter, the height is longer here, but width is the same. Okay, this is a tip. So this is the how many rows you want. Okay, all right, so I'm going to show you the chart that you need here. So starting from 4 to 20 foundation stitches and rows. Okay, so this is a chart. So please use this chart when you determine how many rows. This is the underbust chart. So if you have 65, if you are 65, please choose from 13 or 15 rows. If you have 105, please choose 21, 23, 25 like that. So you can follow by this chart. Okay. All right. So this is the technique that this is the information that you need to determine part rows. And then you can crochet the let's crochet the edging. So let's crochet edging and stoling together. This design is has a stoling on top here, but this is just the one way to crochet. So after making our edging shells on the top edging, please add chains here. So I'm going to show you how to do it. After making these two blah pairs, we are going to reinforce it. So I'm going to show you how to reinforce as well. Okay, so let's continue to crochet. Okay, I finished 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, and 17 rows here. After making chain slip, that is multiples of 8 stitches plus 1, and turn your work, and please add 2 more double crochet in a stitch. And skip 1 stitch and the next stitch, make single crochet. And skip 1 and next stitch, please make 5 double crochet and start the shell. Like this. So you can make start with the slip double crochet. But I'm going to make the start with the single crochet. So if you are multiple of 8 stitches and plus 5, please follow this rule, chain 1 and turn your work and make single crochet and skip 1 and into the next stitch make 5 double crochet. And skip 1 and next stitch make single crochet and skip 1 and next stitch make 5 double crochet again. So just the difference is only in only when they're starting. So after that, just of starting and ending, and after that is the same. Okay, please continue to the top of the bullet part here. And this is should be the right side. Okay, I lace to the top and there is 1, 2, 3 stitches. So please make a 5 double crochet first. After making 5 double crochet, in my case, I'm going to make chain 160 or longer you need or shorter you need. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 5, 6, 12. So let me count one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I'm 14, 15, 16. And 17, 18, 19, and 20. So it's better to mark the stitch, not to forget how many stitches, by every 20 stitch. That is my rule. So if you mark 20 stitches, every 20 stitch, then if you see the 5 markers, it means the 100, right? And if you see the 2, that means 40. So easy to count, okay? All right, I made 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, and 160. Okay, after making 160, please make chain 1 and turn your chains to the other side, and there is 1, 2, 3, 4 back bumps like this. So please use skip the first one and into the second back bump and please make a slip stitch and then into the next back bump please make a slip stitch like this. So please make 160 slip stitches into the back every back bump. So that you can make or you know endless strap code. Oh, excuse me, and no need to sew onto the body, just you know, just non-stop crocheting as we like. Okay, finished. So let's check the length. So that is approximately 77, so I think the gauge is almost 20. That is right in my case. Okay, so let's crochet. And so I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 double crochet here, so please make 4 more. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the total is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 stitches on top of the bra here. And then please crochet the same way to the other side of the edge. Here, stitch of the lower side. So chain one and into the same stitch, make single crochet, and into the next stitch, make single crochet. Oops. So every stitch, make single crochet. Every row, make single crochet. So that is better to pick up the stitch. Okay, and here. So this one is in the middle. This one, so I'm going to skip here. Right, this is the center line, so I'm going to skip the stitch in this way, in here. Otherwise, we will misunderstand the stitch. This one is a single crochet. Okay, so this is a point to end. And 24, 25, 26. 7, 8, 9, 31, 1, 2, 3, 4, 34 stitches per. So okay, this is the last single crochet here, and this. And pull through and make a knot, not to be loosened. Okay, this is the panels to attach on the bust. And then we Hola, you finished till this line now. So let's move to the under bust. And the under bust, we are going to add some belt here. Here, that is buttoned, okay? So how to determine the under bust? Please check under bust, that is 75 and page 3. The page 3 is here. And 75, and I chose the bullet part rows. And look at the light section. Okay, there are stitches, and the numbers 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 are for the pattern. So the 10 means 10 times repeating. 11 is 11 times like that. So in my case, I will repeat 12 times of repeating of the stitch that I'm going to show you, this stitch. So 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to repeat 12 times. And here, I need 142 stitches here. Okay, look at here. There are some even numbers indicate in blue and odd numbers indicate in black. There is a difference. Okay, if you are your size is even stitches, please look at here. We need one between these black parts. If you are odd number in black, there is no stitches needed. Okay, so this is the technique that you need here. And after you determine 142 stitches, let's divide how to attach. Okay, look at page 2. And I have 142 stitches and even stitches. And there are reinforcement. And how to reinforce? The reinforce is here. And I chose the long design or short design, whatever. I need a same number in this case. This is, I chose 17. This one, 17 by 2 is 34. That is a reinforced stitches. So this is 2 and reinforced. So that's why 34 by 2. And minus 9. The minus 9, I'm going to describe later. Right now, just minus 9. And if you are even stitches, please minus 1. And after that, divide into 2. So that's the right side and left side size. So in my case, it's 32. Okay? This is how to calculate. So please check the number here. If you are in blue, please look at this calculation. If you want number is in black, please use this calculation. Okay, all right, next let's talk about our 9 stitches here. So the 9 stitches is this one, it's 9. 9 is for buttonhole tab, and I would like to make 2 buttonholes here, and I end with in 10 rows, and I need tab in 9 stitches. So 4 stitches for the end, 1 stitch is for the buttonhole position, and 4 stitches for the inner. So let's make like this, 9 stitches and 10 rows. And also in 10 rows, 2 rows and 1 buttonhole, 4 rows and 1 buttonhole row and 2 rows. That is a 10 rows. So that's why I need 9 stitches here. 9. 9 comes from this 9. It is the bottom hole belt like this. This one is 9 stitches. Okay. All right. Then I found 32 is the rough backband numbers. So right side is 32 and left side is 32 plus 9 is 41. Okay. So 32 and 41. And if you prefer to longer here and shorter here, you can change the number right and left opposite way. And also if you want to open the buttonhole on left, just same, please open in the shorter band and leave the longer band okay as is. Okay, all right, so let's make let's divide and let's make chains and attach black pads and make the so this band under bust band. So look at page 4 here. Okay, so from the long side, I start with 32 plus 9 and 34 for the first black pad and 1 for even number and 34 for next black pad and 32 for the right side back band. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to do it. Okay, this is a light side, but please upside down and long side of up. Okay, like this. Now this is separated, so I'm going to attach both. Okay. And let's make a slip knot. One, two, three, four. Pick the first panel and please whip the yarn end and please insert into the first stitch. So it's going to be very obvious. This is the first stitch. I believe you won't miss it. Please attach with single crochet. Then please make single crochet into every stitch. It's going to be 34. So please crochet while weaving the end. Okay, see you at the end of this panel. And this is the last stitch, so please make another single crochet and please make chain one and pick the other panel and then please continue to crochet single crochet into every stitch. One, let me make one, sorry for the noise. Okay, so see you at the end. After reaching to the last stitch, please make chain the rest of chains. Alright, so let's start. Please make chain one and turn your work. So in this case, please look at this. We are going to crochet top down and look at these chains. The back bumps came up on top. So we should crochet under the V chain. So I added another chain and turn your work and into the second chain. So please pick the back bump from farther to closer at turn your work. So now under the V chain and then pull up a loop and make a single crochet. So like this. Okay, you can do like this. Insert under the back bump and make a single crochet. You can crochet either way, in better way, or just under the V chain. So it's going to make your fabric very straight and nice look. Okay, please continue and see you at the end of chain. Alright, this is the last stitch, so please insert into under the chain and then make a single crochet. And this is the first stitch, so please make single crochet. And please continue and please make a single crochet this chain one space and then crochet and into chains and see you at the end of this row. Well, I finished to the end and this is the light side and this is the row one. Okay, move to the row two. Finish row 2 and move to row 3, and row 3 we are going to make the buttonhole, so please crochet to the end and let's see you at the end and let's make buttonhole together. So chain 1 and turn and work and please continue crochet single crochet into every stitch. So please continue single crochet. Alright, this is the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 stitches. So let's crochet together. One, two, three, four single crochet and chain one and skip one and four single crochet again. 2, 3, and 4. So here it's a buttonhole. Okay, move on to row 4. Chain 1 and turn and work. And please make 4 single crochet first. 2, 3, and 4. And here is chain 1, so you can insert into under the V chain to make a single crochet, or you can into the space and make single crochet. I prefer this way because I can open the hole. Okay, then please continue single crochet to the end. And after that, please crochet 4 rows and then please repeat this procedure. And then 2 single crochet rows. Okay, so let's see you at the next buttonhole position. And let's see you once again. Alright, see you later. Okay, next is row 8 and I'm going to make another buttonhole like this. Chain 1 and turn and work. And let's make 4 double crochet first. 4 double crochet and chain 1 and skip 1 and into next stitch. And please continue to single crochet. And next is row 9 and please make a reinforce this stitch hole and then finish with row 10. Okay, finish the under bust band and there are 2 buttonholes here. Okay, now you finish the bra part, so you can wear it as the halter neck bra as is. And if you want to make it a camisole, please continue this one. Okay, this design. So I'm going to show you how to crochet this beautiful pattern together. That is very easy. And also, how about design? And I picked the design to open and close with buttons. And also, I opened here and here to make more opening space to wear and on and wear off very easily. So the first 8 rows we are going to crochet back and forth and open the center line here. And after 8 rows, I will attach in a tube. And so after that, let's crochet in the round, but still back and forth, and join into the middle line. And I did this one. It's quite nice looks, even this is joined. So I think this is not so much ugly, but if you don't like it, please join at the end or any other area, okay? All right. Also, in this design, I would like to increase some. So I will show you how to do it. Okay, first, let's determine body rows. So, please check the total height. The total height here is 27. Okay, so look at here. 27 is total height. And everyone has bust bound in 4 centimeters, so please minus 4. It is 23 centimeters, approximately 9 inches. And when I calculate, that is 28 rows. So I can understand I need 28 rows. Okay, so from here to here is 28. Next, I would like to increase here and here. How? Okay, let's calculate. So look at number 5. Check this hip size or finishing size. I need 90 centimeters. So it is in the gauge, 20 stitches, 90 centimeters. It means 180 stitches. Okay. And also look at the first stitches. I started 142. That is 12 pattern repeating. Okay. This pattern contains from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 double crochet and 6 stitches. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stitches. So it is in 11 stitches in a pattern. So I repeated 12 times. So it means 132, but I have to add 1 here because I want to start 3 and I want to finish with 3. So 3 and 3. So actually 5, but now here is 3 and 3. So I need one more. So that's why I need 133. It is approximately 47 stitches. Or maybe you can just 11 and 12 is 132. So it can be 48. Okay. So we need 47 stitches to increase. How often and how? Okay, let's check frequency. So let's look at number 3 here. I have 12 times repeating here. So this is your chart. So there is a number. There are the numbers that you have to repeat. I have 12 times repeating of this design. Okay, let's check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So I repeated 12 times. So 48 divided into 12 is 4 times. Okay, so now I know I need to increase 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4 times. How many rows? I need 28 rows. So 28 divided into 7. No. 4 is 7 times. So every 7th row, we are going to increase. But if we increase at 7th, we have to increase at the end. That is not good. So, and if we start increase at the first, it is still not good. So I recommend you to start 1, 2, 3, or 4 like this. So in the middle of the pattern repeating, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If this is the 7, so please increase in the middle like this. And I will also show you how to crochet this pattern and how to crochet to increase, okay, and how often a line. So this is the pattern for the body. The body is very simple. Now I think you understand what we are going to do. So let's crochet this beautiful pattern together and let's enjoy this camisole. So, and also please increase and to make a line. And if you want longer design, please crochet long dress with this pattern, okay? This is very nice for summer season. All right, so let's continue to crochet together. Okay, let's crochet this pattern together. This design is starting from 3 double crochet, and before that I have to leave 9 stitches. So I mark this one. All right, let's crochet together, starting with gently, count as a double. But in that case, I would reinforce the first stitch, so chain 1 and turn your work, and in the first stitch, let's make single crochet and chain 2, so that the stitch is going to be a little bit tighter. Then, please make 2 more double crochet here and here. After that, please skip 1 and 2. Into the next stitch, please make 5 double crochet and then chain 2, 1, 2, and then skip 1, 2, 3. After skipping 1, 2, 3 stitches, into the next stitch, make 5 double crochet. After making 5 double crochet, skip 1, 2, and into the third chain, make double crochet. The double crochet is yarn over, insert yarn over, pull up a loop, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops. One, two, three, four, five. After making 5 double crochet, please make chain 2. Skip 3, 1, 2, 3. Into the next stitch, double crochet 5 times. You got it? It's very simple and easy pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, next, skip 2 and into the next stitch, 5 double crochet. And chain 2. And skip 1, 2, 3 and into the next stitch, make double crochet and 5 double crochet. So please repeat this pattern until the end, and please leave 9 stitches, and see you at the end. So let's count 1 pattern, 2 pattern, 1, 2, 3 now. So let's make 12 in my case, and let's make your numbers. Okay, at the last finish with the third double crochet. So it means starting with 3 double crochet here and end with 3 double crochet here, okay? All right, so let's move to row 2. Row 2 also start with chain 3, count as a double, and turn your work. Please make double crochet into double crochet. So after making 3 double crochet without any chain, please find the first double crochet, so in this case this one. Into the first double crochet, please make 5 double crochet. One, two, three, four, five. Then chain 2 as a previous row and skip these shells and into the first double crochet here. So this is 5 double crochet. Then into the first double crochet, make double crochet after chain 2. Then please make double crochet into double crochet. So it means 5 double crochet here. After 5 double crochet, skip this chain 2 and into the first double crochet, make 5 double crochet. One, two, three, four, five. Then make chain 2. And into the 5 double crochet after the shell. Please make 5 double crochet again. Okay, repeat. Into the first double crochet here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and chain 2. And into the 5 double crochet, make the 5 double crochet. The shell is like offset. So please continue this design to the end. Okay, I forgot to mention to the third chain. So after finishing, please insert into the third chain, that is a turning chain. So 1, 2, 3, this one. And finish the second round. So after making the last double crochet, start with chain 3 and continue. Okay, first. Okay, chain 3, count as a double, and turn your work. The first stitch of this one. So anyway, please make 2 more double crochet here. And without any chains, into the 5 double crochet, the first double crochet, and make 5 double crochet. It's kind of scallop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and chain 2. And in the first stitch, we are going to increase. So 1, 2. Next 4 more, yarn into the first stitch, make 5 double crochet as usual. This stitch is very easy, so and easy to increase and beautiful, so it's very useful. Okay, and then in the first double crochet of the 5 double crochet, let's increase in the same stitch again and increased. So now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then next is 5 double crochet into the first 5 double crochet loop and chain 2. Then skip these 5 double crochet and into the 5 double crochet block. So this one. So what we should do, we increase here. So into every first double crochet or 5 double crochet straight line, please increase. Okay, after the last chain to space, there are 1, 2, 3 doubles left. And usually we have to increase here, but in this case, we don't increase to match the number to 6 double crochet. So just double crochet into every stitch. Okay, so finish with 3 again. And then next stitch, next round, start with chain 3 and turn your work. And start with 3 doubles. Okay, the 5 can divide into half, but 6 can divide into half, so 3 and 3 now is barely even. And then please make 5 double crochet into the first double crochet of the shell scallop. 3 and 4, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 double crochet and chain 2. And after that, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 doubles here. So please make 6 double crochet one by one. Then 5 double crochet here. Alright, finish 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 rows, and that is approximately 6 centimeters. It is almost 2.5 here. Okay, so it is almost 4 inches, and that is 10 centimeters. So we are going to close here, and after that, let's crochet in the round and back and forth. So let's close here. There is 1, 2, 3, the third turning chain inside it, and slip stitch to join. Okay, so let's turn your work. It's from the long side, so chain 1. And this is the last stitch. So let's make single crochet to lane false. And I would like to mark the last stitch to not to forget. So 1, 2, 3, this one. And start with chain 2, count as a double. So please make double crochet. And please continue this pattern. Alright, let's check the widths first. 13 here. So it is mostly 26. And how about this one? This one is 14, so it's approximately 2.01 inch wider. So this is 34 here, and this is 36. So it's approximately 2 inches and 5 centimeters. And this is the last stitch of this round, so please make another double crochet and join into the third chain of the first stitch. So here, this one, single crochet, chain one, and next one, this one. No, is that? Oh, yeah, this one. Okay. All right, next, chain one and turning work. And this is the next stitch. So please make single crochet and chain two. Okay, then mark the last stitch, not to forget. Okay, let's chain the yarn to the new yarn here. And where is it? Okay, this is the yarn end of the new yarn. So leave approximately 6 inches, approximately 15 centimeters. And please make double crochet into the halfway. Okay, this is the halfway, and do not finish, and release old yarn. And this is the long side, so pull it to the long side, and then please pick the new yarn, and then pull through remaining two loops. So now changed, and let's weave the yarn end, and let's continue to crochet. So after finishing, please weave the yarn end. Okay, so next round is increasing round, so let's crochet together. And on the last row, we did at the light, so we need to make left. So let's make two double crochet at the left from the light side. And 5 double crochet again here, and then chain 2 and to the next block earlier, and please increase at the left. So this one, first double and the next double, so make 2 and into the double crochet and 5 double crochet. And chain 2. So at the left and light and left and light. So change like this. So look at here, we did at the left here. And then next, we did at the light here, and next, left and light and left and light and left and light, like this, okay? Well, I supposed to make the border, and I tried a single crochet in the border like this, but it doesn't work very well. I prefer this loose ending, so I'm done. I skip any border. So after joining and chain one and finish this work. All right, let's close sew the button. Okay, so let's sew the button. And I prefer lock the button first. So after doing this, divide here and pull through here. Okay, so now locked. Okay, let's sew from the top. And I mark the button stitch at the fifth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. Okay, finished. How the explanation, and how was it? Is it still difficult for you? I think this it was really many sizes and many numbers that I showed you, but it is because of everyone has every sizes, so everyone has different size, so it is good to use this chart, pick your numbers and then crochet like this, so you can crochet as same as mine. Okay, so this is really easy. Also, if it's according to your age and according to your size, the part size is also different, but it is very natural, very simple, and just single crochet and double crochet pattern, so it's very easy and not so many increasing and not so many irregular designs. So I think that is very simple still, so I think you can understand really well. But if you have any questions or suggestions, please write to me in comment sections, and it is very useful for me for your suggestion. And if you have any questions, I would like to answer your question as much as possible. But actually, I think I explained everything about the details in this video. So I hope you understand, and I wish you want to crochet this halter neck camisole. This is very good for summer. Okay. Alright. So this is very simple design and simple work. So please enjoy this crochet camisole. Alright. Thank you very much, and see you next time. Bye bye.